Up until this point, we've only dealt with exponents that were either positive or negative integers. Today, we're going to look at exponents of another form. I'd like to look at exponents in the form of 1 over n. Say we have x raised to the 1 over n, we can rewrite that as the nth root of x, where x to the 1 over n is written in exponential form, and the nth root of x is written in radical form. These two expressions are equal, and I also wanted to point out that this n is the index of the radical. So let's explore. We have 8 raised to the 1/3, and you can see that my x is 8, so where I have x, I replace that with an 8. My n is 3, so I replace the n with 3, and now I have the cube root of 8. Now we know the cube root of 8 is 2 because this is really asking me what number multiplied by itself 3 times gives me 8. The answer is 2, because 2 times 2 times 2 is indeed 8. We can verify this with our graphing calculator by entering 8 raised to the 1 divided by 3 in parentheses, right? So 8 raised to the 1 divided by 3 is the same as 8 to the 1/3. We press enter, and we have 2. We can also enter this expression into our calculator. If I press 3, that's for the cube root, and I press the math key, you see where we have number 5, I'm going to arrow down to highlight number 5, that's saying my index is x. Well, we already entered 3 for my index, so I press the 5 key, and you see now I'm taking the third root of, we're going to take the third root of 8. So this, it looks a little different than what I have written on the screen, but this is essentially the same expression, right? The cube root of 8, or the third root of 8. I press enter, and I get 2 as well. Now let's take a look at exponents of the form m over n. That's m as in Mary over n as in Nancy. We can write this two ways. Option A, x to the m over n is the nth root of x, all raised to the mth power. Option B is the nth root of x to the m. So it doesn't matter if I take this whole expression and raise it to the mth power, or if I actually put that underneath the radical symbol. We're going to do a few examples both ways to verify that the answer should still be the same. Before I move on, one thing I want to point out, a lot of my students mix up the m and the n. They're not sure if the m goes here or the n goes here. Just think, if this was a flower, the root would be on the bottom, and the flower or the power would be on the top. So the root n goes on the bottom, and the power m goes on the top. Again, this is written in exponential form, and this is written in radical form. So your teacher might give you one or the other and ask you to write in a different form. So I might give you something in exponential form and say rewrite in radical form, or I could give you something in radical form and ask you to rewrite in exponential form. You should feel comfortable doing this. So using option A, if I were to give you 8 raised to the 2/3, well, this 2/3 can be broken apart, right? 1/3 times 2 is still 2/3. So now we have 8 raised to the 1/3, and the power is on the outside, so this is all raised to the 2nd. And think about it, 2 times 1/3 is 2/3. So we really haven't changed anything here. We've just rewritten it several times. Now, remember, in parentheses here, 8 to the 1/3 can be rewritten as the cube root of 8, and that's all squared. So if you look at this as the 2 equals m, the m goes on the outside, like you see here. The n is 3, that goes in the index, just like you see the n here, and x stays where it is, so the 8 stays underneath the radical symbol. So when we actually evaluate this, the cube root of 8 is 2, 2 squared is 4, right? Remember, this is asking you what number multiplied by itself 3 times gives you 8. That answer is 2, then 2 squared equals 4. We can verify this result using our calculator. So first, let's enter the original problem. We had 8 raised to the 2 divided by 3. Press enter. My calculator gives me 4. Now, to enter this in radical form, well, we're going to have parentheses, because this first piece is going to go in parentheses. The index is 3. I press the math key. Number 5. So now I have the third root of 8. I'm going to close my parentheses, and this is all squared, so it's all raised to the second, right? Everything inside parentheses is raised to the second. I press enter, and we get 4. Now let's look at option B. This time, I'm putting the 2 in front of the 1/3. I'm doing 2 times 1/3. In the previous example, I did 1/3 times 2. So when I break this apart into 2 times 1/3, this becomes 8 raised to the second in parentheses, and the 1/3 is on the outside. Again, if I multiply the 2 times the 1/3, I get 2/3. So now I'm squaring the 8, and I'm taking the cube root of everything inside parentheses. So when we clean this up, 8 squared is 64. What number multiplied by itself 3 times would give me 64? Well, 4 times 4 is 16. 16 times 4 is 64. Again, to verify our answer, we pull up our trusty calculator, and I'm going to enter exactly what I see here. So the third root of, let's hit the math key, number 5. Now it's 8 squared. So I'm going to put this in parentheses. 8 raised to the second power. Right? So this looks like what I have here. The third root of 8 squared. The third root of 8 squared. I press enter. And we get 4. So we're in business. If we look at options A and options B side by side, here you can see the everything in parentheses is squared. And in option B, I actually brought the second power underneath the radical symbol. And either way we do this, we get the same answer. The big thing is to make sure you have the correct index. If you feel a little fuzzy about this, the next video, I'm actually going to do a few problems on the blackboard by hand. So look for the videos that have a BB next to them. That indicates blackboard or a blackboard example. Thank you for watching and take care.